record and then come round here, woman's ears. Morning, guys. I'm Chris. This is Danny. Welcome to Viking Ventures UK. And we're going to be doing a review of this BSA Goldstar 650. So stay tuned. Right, well, we'll have a bit of a look around the bike and see how she's looking, because she looks really good. She looks really good. What do you think?
Yeah, no, it's nice.
It's got a lovely shiny, nice finish to it. It's a liquid called 652cc. A lot of people have said that they don't particularly like this radiator on the front, but I just think we're at that sort of age now where everything should be liquid cooled. It is a twin spark setup as well, electronic fuel injection. I love the finish, you know, of the engine casings and stuff, and it's all BSA badged up, and you've got the traditional three guns logo, which is really nice. Yeah, the fit and finish of the bike seems to be very, very nice. It's a 41mm telescopic non-adjustable forks on the front, 5-point adjustable coils on the rear. It's got a 320mm front disc with a twin pot Brembo front caliper, a 255mm single pot Brembo caliper on the rear. I do like the fact that they've kept this distance between the back wheel and the mudguard. It might look a little bit odd, but that is quite traditional to the original DBD 34 500 Goldstar, because that was exactly the same as the old bike. But I think that the overall fit and finish of the bike is really nice. It's got nice wide grips, very light clutch, which is obviously very nice for a first-time rider. No overall travel of the levers or anything like that. Handlebars are very nice, lovely chrome finish. Everything seems to be of very good quality. Yeah, the switch gear is very nice. That seems to be of a good quality as well. Everything's nice and chunky, so I'd imagine that if you had thick gloves on, or anything like that, that you'd easily be able to use these controls with no problem at all. Even comes with a USB point on the front of the bike as well. You can see there. So you've got a USB-C and you've got a USB traditional charging point, which is obviously very good to have on a bike like this. It comes prepared and ready for use. I love that tank fuel cap as well. That's really nice, that. That's really, really cool. I like that. The finish of the mirrors is really nice. I don't think they're overly big, but I think that they're going to be absolutely ideal for the job that they're designed for. But overall, yeah, the fit and finish of the bike is really, really nice. I really do. I like it. I love the fact as well that the old voltmeter has been converted. This is your neutral. Hang on, let me get the key. So yeah, your neutral, your engine lights, your ABS, you know, all of that's been converted, you know, for a modern thing. So even the indicators run through there. I like that. You've got hazard lights as well, which is obviously a nice touch. You've got an information panel on this lovely LCD display. I mean, these clocks are awesome as well, because this is really traditional. And I really like the fact that they're kind of like a backwards facing clock. They're really nice. I do like it. Embroidery's nice on the seat. Got the nice Union Jack little tab thing there. That's really cool. It's a lovely finished bike. You know, I'm actually quite surprised. And as well, if you buy a new one of these, I think they're roughly around, in especially in this colour, because I think there's like five different colours now, that you get a 4-year warranty with the new bike. But if you already own one of these bikes, BSA will actually extend your warranty up to 4 years. So even if you originally only got 3 years, they will upgrade you to 4 years, which is obviously really good. Gives you that peace of mind that when you buy a new bike, you know, that at least the manufacturer is going to look after you like that. So that's it's really good, really, really good. I like that. Love the fit and finish of the front mudguard. I think this is really nice finish. It feels a lot higher quality than the price tag would suggest. It feels very close to, I would probably say, like the Triumph Bonneville, like the finish. It's lovely. I do like it, really like it. Weight wise, it's 213 kilograms wet, which to me, I'm 6'3", 15 stone, so this doesn't really feel overly heavy to me at all. It feels nice and light. I can plant both feet nicely on the ground. A lovely upright feel to the bike. Suspension feels nice and soft, which I think this, you know, for the type of job that this bike is designed for, I think is going to be absolutely ample. It has a outstanding 45 brake horsepower, 55 newton meters of torque. So it's not going to pull your arms out of the sockets by any stretch of the imagination, but it is going to be a nice feeling of power, especially if you are a new rider and you're looking for your first big bike. This will be very, very forgiving. I think it's going to be nice and easy to ride. I think the character of the single cylinder engine gives a nice traditional feel about the riding of the bike. I'm looking forward to getting this out on the road and having a bit of a sprinkle with it, because it's a lovely day. It's 12 degrees in December. So I'm gonna get out onto the road, have a bit of a fly around, and see what I think of it. But I just think that, yeah, if this would be an ideal first bike. You know, if you're into modern retros, this would be perfect, to be honest, because it hasn't got the power which is gonna, you know, put you off. It's not overly heavy. You can quite comfortably put your feet on the ground, which is obviously confidence inspiring. It's just, yeah, it's a nice, nicely finished bike. But what do you think?
Let's go on the road and see what we think from there.
Let's do that. Right then, let's mount this, the Steed. Let's just have a closer look at these ear clocks. They do look very nice. I do like these. Well, it's got quite a nice note that comes out of it. Oh, that's nice. That is nice. Let's mount up. Oh, gearbox feels very nice. Controls are very nice. It really does sound really good, this bike. I'm actually quite surprised. I do feel quite big for it though. But yeah, it changes direction nicely. Yeah. Right, so I do have a bit of a better clue of where I'm going this time round. Oh, gearbox actually really nice. Oh, it's got a little bit of pep to it as well. A bit peppy, you know, for 40 odd horsepower bike. We will go left. There's a bit of a snatchiness and overrun on the throttle, but I think that's just a case of me just getting used to this little machine. But it is, up to now, this feels like a very nice seating position. Suspension is very soft. As I say, I'm not the fattest of people, but 15 stone lad on it. But it's quite a nice, yeah, very nice riding position. But the controls are so easy, and it feels incredibly light when you're on it. It really does. shut the old visor. We will be going right as well. Yeah, the controls are very, very user-friendly. I like this. Very user-friendly. First gear's got a weird, like it doesn't like sit firm once you get into first. It's got a bit of a floppy lever, but it feels good. It's yeah, nice little feeling bike this. It's not overly vibey. It's got a nice little bit of character to it. The gearbox is super nice, really user friendly. Throttle response is nice and relaxed as well. Obviously, you know, a 650 single. I mean, it feels like it's got, I mean, if I give it a good twist here now, it feels like it's got quite a lot of pep, to be fair, for a little single cylinder. Yeah, I like that. I do. We'll test the brakes a little bit further up here. But now this has got a proposed fuel consumption of 70 to the gallon, so it's very efficient. A lot of people have had concern over, obviously, BSA's reliability, because they don't know with sales, you know, whether it's going to be a worthwhile investment for people. But I mean, the garage where we got this bike from very kindly donated it for us to us for the day. Is Eddie's Moto in Tadcaster. So if you're looking for an awesome deal on your first big bike, modern retro. I mean, they're a Royal Enfield dealership as well. They do the, you know, you can get the Interceptor 650 from there, the Himalayan. They do a few other, you know, cool old school bikes. I'm sure Eddie will be more than happy to assist in any way possible. But yeah, up to now, this is feeling really nice. Let's go down here. Seems like this is the sort of roads that this bike was made for. Up to now, yeah, this is feeling really, really good. Picks up nice and easy. Gearbox is really good. Let's just try the back brake. It's got ABS front and rear as well, so you'll always have that reassurance that at least if it's slippy underfoot, you're going to be able to stop. Torque's nice. Changes direction nicely. Yeah, really nice. Quite springy, to be fair. Bouncy little thing. But yeah, it's full of character, this bike. Absolutely full of it. Engine's lovely. Nice and characterful. Got a lovely sound that comes out of it as well. Doesn't obviously have rider modes, because, well, let's face it, why would you? The more electronics there are on bikes, the more things there are to go wrong, as they say. But yeah, I really do like this. You could have a lot of fun on this bike. A lot of fun. Let's take it a little bit easier around some of these bends though, because it is a little bit slippy underfoot still. Wouldn't be mind getting to somewhere where the roads are a bit drier. Give her a proper swing about, see what it's like. You know, this is a proper working class hero, this. Right, based off a proper working class hero bike anyway. I mean, it's the original 500 Goldstar, I think, had like something like 40, 41, 42 horsepower. You know, so it hasn't gained much over the years, but I just think that this is just a nice ample amount of power, because obviously you're going to be using this bike for, you know, for riding, for fun, you know, and commuting to and from work and things like that. It's great. I really like it. It's got a nice feeling to it. And then obviously, as you've seen, that we are missing one. We've gained a person, but we are missing a person, which is Sam, because you're not going to believe it. Sam is actually ill again. Sam's always ill.
So he's missed out not only on the Norton, but on the BSA as well. So let's have a bit of a squeeze and see what this thing can do. Do you know what? That's actually all right, that. I'd be happy. I would. It's like you've got the a little bit of vibration, you know, through the handlebars and the footrest, but at the end of the day, it is a single cylinder bike. Mirrors are, yeah, very good. No over or excessive vibration. Yeah, I like this. This is a nice place to be. Nice place to be. Very easy. Very simple workhorse of a machine. It feels really light. I do feel quite, I think my knees are a little bit cramped, but as I say, I'm quite tall, you know, so I just think for, you know, if there's somebody who's obviously around, you know, 5'7", 5'8", I think this would be, you know, a lovely comfortable machine. The seat does feel very good, I will say that. It feels very comfortable. You know, I'm not like lent over the handlebars or anything like that. I've got a nice upright seating position. Just trying to think of anything else. I'm trying not to give it too much credit, to be honest, as I say, because I do like to give a completely honest review of all these bikes that we do and try and behave myself through some of these speed restricted areas. I love these clocks, you know. It's just looking down. I think my only criticism of the clocks should probably be that they're not angled quite up enough. But I mean, you can still see them perfectly well. I love the light, you know, the colour, the background colour of them and stuff. I think they're really cool. It's just obviously, yeah, they just look a little bit flat. Right, let's try keep the revs down as low as possible, because any single cylinder that I've ever owned, you get them right the way down at the bottom of the rev range and you get like this very overpowering thudiness which is going on. But you know what, I'm getting absolutely nothing. This is silky smooth. This is probably the smoothest single cylinder I've ever ridden this. Another reason why this would make for a perfect first time modern retro bike. And it's obviously oozing with character. It's very nice. Lovely, well-balanced machine. You know, even at slow speeds there, sometimes you just feel a little bit more compelled to put your foot down when you come to a slow stop or anything. But no, the throttle response is very nice. Obviously there's a lot of input needed to get it to move, but you know, it's I think that can only work in someone's benefit who's new to the to biking. I think that the brakes are really good, to be honest. The you know, the feedback that you get from the brakes is really cool. I like that. They've got a nice assuring feel to them. Yeah, that torque from the engine's nice. This is a really, really nice little bike, this. I think this has definitely got a bit more pep to it than the Interceptor 650. Even though the Interceptor's a 650 twin and has roughly around about the same power, I think this has got a little bit more get up and go to it. It certainly feels lighter. The braking feels superior. And it's in a similar price range, but as you know, as we said before, I think this this silver version is going to be around $7,000+. I could be mistaken, but I will put a correction on screen if needed. So it's a little bit more expensive than the Interceptor, but I just think that you've got a better fit and finish, you know, so it's probably going to be worth spending that extra bit of money. It's just such a nice little bike. It's really well balanced. I really like it. I will take it down some of these. I want to get onto some twisties. See what it feels like through the corners, you know, when you push it on a little bit. You know, you're not always going to be riding around town and stuff. You're going to want to get out and just have a bit of a thrutch. You know, stretch its legs a little bit. I don't want to be collecting no puppy dogs. So suspension does feel really nice, changes direction lovely. Now this is a national speed limit road. I don't think I'm taking the piss, I'm just having a bit of a squeeze about, and it feels very good, very good. I'm literally flat out at the moment. I don't want to be taking the piss with the bike, obviously, because whereas Eddie might be reluctant to let me test another one. It's just stretching its legs within reason. Don't know where I am, but back brake is very nice. Handling seems very good. Yeah. Lovely jubbly, lovely jubbly. So we'll have a we'll go straight on here. I want to see what's down this road. This looks quite juicy for this sort of bike. Oh, you put your feet down so easy. This is going to make someone a lovely first time bike, this. So first and second gear a little bit shorter, so let's just give it a bit of a down here. Right, I can feel the suspension bottoming out a little bit. Obviously I'm a bit of a chunk. Obviously this is it's set to its softest setting as well, so we have to give it a little bit of a bit of leeway. But yeah, that feels nice. Feels nice, a little fun bike, commuter bike. You could have plenty of fun on this. Yeah, I really like it. I really like it. It's a nice little bike. Lovely jubbly. Now we'll go this way. We'll go this way. But it's such a nice day that I can't believe it's bloody December. You know, 12 degrees. Ah, that exhaust noise is really good. I like that. Braking's, as I say, is really good. Overall fit and finish is brilliant. I love the attention to detail. You know, even the BSA logo on the side of the tank is nice. Handlebars are lovely, nice and chunky. I think if you're a young lady or a young lad and you've got small hands, I think you might struggle a little bit because these are quite chunky, but at least you've got something nice and thick and juicy to hold on to. What else are we saying here? I just can't get over how nice those clocks are. I didn't think I'd like them as much as I do, but I do. I really like them. Nice and fruity. It is a very lovely, smooth bike. Very easy to control, easy to manage. I say with that combined fuel consumption as well, that's, you know, obviously 70 to the gallon on a 650. Yeah, fair enough, it is a single. That's really good, really, really good. I like that. Missus seems to like it as well. Obviously she's new to biking, you know, she's recently passed the test. She's on SV650S. She's not really spent too much time riding it, to be honest, but you know, she passed just before winter, and it's not a good idea to get her out throughout winter. And obviously with me, I like keeping my bikes clean at all times without fail, so she kind of taken after me with things like that. But let's see what this little baby is like throughout town. It's going to spend most of its life, I think, as a working machine, probably just trundling around, you know, to and from work, getting stuck in the busy traffic that we have on these roads. Doesn't look overly too busy today, but No, it's I quite like this place actually, Tadcaster or whatever it's called. It's nice. My brother is missed out again. He'd have liked to have test rode this bike. He's been on about it for a while now, but he was ill during the Norton test and he's ill during this one. Lad's always bloody ill. But yeah, I mean, you're not going to be pulling any wheelies on this bike anytime soon. The power is very forgiving. It's super easy. It's super affordable. You know, I think if you're obviously in the market for a modern retro, this would be a very, very good bike to have a go at and see how it feels for you. Obviously, you know, we might do these reviews and what I might think is good, someone else might think is crap. So you're always better off test riding any bike before you buy it. Obviously, if you're on a restricted license, though, that's where it can become a little bit difficult, because you can't test ride a bike if you're on an A2 license, restricted, which is absolutely stupid. Because if you're like my younger brother Joe, he's done more miles in a couple of years than most people have. You know, in like 10 years, he's done like 50,000 miles on his last bike. It was crazy. You know, and he's got to have to go in and redo his test, you know, just because he's on an A2 restricted license. I don't understand what the crack is with that. They should have allowed, you know, anyone on an A2, if you're riding for a couple of years, to automatically upgrade. But obviously the government likes taking your money and stuff, so yeah, they can force you to bloody retake your test. Which ain't good. I wonder what this spot is. Oh, I've taken a wrong turn. Bugger. Do 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 do. Turning circles nice. Have a little pull up here, do a bit of a talk.
So guys, what do we think about this machine? It looks good, it performs really well. I'm actually really impressed with the braking. The brakes are really, really nice. The overall fit and finish of the bike is really good. I do really like some of these features on it, like the traditional pea shooter-esque exhaust. I know that this the overall diameter of the downpipe here has been changed because a lot of people said it was too thick and chunky, but I don't know who is going to turn down a thick pipe. It is just very nice, very nice. I like the handling. Handling's really good, really forgiving. The power of the engine feels a lot more than what it should at 45 horsepower. I'm really, really happy with it. I think it looks really nice. Really nice. I think this would really make somebody a beautiful first time modern retro bike. You know, obviously if you're in the market for this sort of thing, because it's very comfortable, it's very easy to use. It's lovely. I love that badge as well. The badge just looks awesome. Obviously I've got a bit of experience of BSAs. You know, I've had a few. Me and my dad built one when I was, must have been about 12. 13, B40 scrambler. It was, yeah, really, really nice. Really nice bikes. And I think this definitely has some of that old character. I love the character of the engine. It's got a lot of usable power. You know, not too much, not too little. I think it's just right. But I think the Royal Enfield are going to be a little bit, what's the right word? Rugged, I think would be the right word, because this is a fine machine. It's roughly around about the same weight, but this definitely does feel lighter. I think the Interceptor's weight is higher up, so it feels higher. But yeah, if you're new to riding, and you're looking for a modern retro, I think this is an absolute blinder. This is really, really nice. I love the finish of the bike is lovely. The riding of the actual bike itself is really nice. I like the fact that it's quite low to the floor. That's going to be quite confidence inspiring for a new time rider, especially after coming off, you know, doing your test. I mean, let's face it, when you do your test, you're going to be on a 650 anyway. Use a Kawasaki ER650F or something like that, or a CB650 or something like that. It's just going to be, yeah, brilliant bike for you to own and ride and appreciate, because it really is a lovely machine. Really, really nice. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to make my way back to Eddie Moto now, which you were kind enough to loan us the bike, and we'll hand it back to him. Because I don't really want to give it back, to be fair. It's a lovely bike. But so I will catch up with you back at the shop.
Well, on the way back to Eddie Moto now. Been a nice little riding machine, this. Nice little rider. Would definitely make a good first bike for somebody, without a doubt. This type of entry level. I mean, even somebody who's been away from biking, or just a BSA enthusiast themselves. It doesn't necessarily have to be a first time bike. It was just, obviously I'm reviewing it from that perspective, because this just would make a lovely first time machine for someone, you know, who's into the old modern retro stuff. It does ride very nicely. No, I'm very impressed with it, to be fair. It's really, really nice. Really nice bike. I do like it. Nice spot, this, as well. But no, shout out to Eddie Moto. Thank you very much for the opportunity. Much appreciated. And as I said earlier, if you fancy coming down for a test ride on one of these lovely bikes, they'll look after you from start to finish. And they've reduced the price now on every single one apart from this. The this lovely silver bike is the only one which isn't reduced in price. So I mean, to be honest, this would probably be the one that I would go for, because it's more of like the traditional colour. But yeah, extended 5-year warranty on all their bikes. 4-year warranty, sorry. Been a lovely, lovely experience thus far. Wait for the wife to just turn this around and put this over here. Nice, that's a nice Royal Enfield, that. I should probably put this here. Yeah, nice machine. But I'll go and hand this back to Eddie, give him my thoughts, and we'll see. See what happens.
Right, well, that concludes our video. And if you've liked our review of the BSA 650 Goldstar, please don't forget to like and subscribe, because this obviously helps our channel grow into something magnificent and beautiful and pretty and wonderful. And we can keep putting these videos out for you. So, thank you very much for watching, and we'll catch you in the next one. Cheers.